Tēnā koutou, welcome back to Q&A and welcome to my panel, Ella Henry, Associate Professor and Director of Māori Advancement at the AUT Faculty of Business, Economics and Law, and PR practitioner, former national staffer, Ben Thomas. Tēnā koutou, happy new year, and thanks for being with us in 2020. Ben, I'll start with you. I want to consider Winston Peters' statements this week regarding the photographs that were taken of two journalists investigating the New Zealand First Foundation. Do you accept Winston Peters' explanation that his party was not responsible for those photos?
Well, yeah, I was going to ask which explanation. So there were two stories. The first was, we took the photos and we did it to show up the journalists, which suggests that actually, the New Zealand First Party was involved in basically stalking some journalists, meeting with sources, and then laundering that in a political attack through the successor to the Whale Oil blog that was involved in dirty politics. His second explanation was, actually, it had nothing to do with us, he tweeted yesterday. So there's a clear conflict of stories. One of the stories really doesn't paint the Deputy Prime Minister of the country in a very good light. The Prime Minister has refused to comment on this so far, saying it's a New Zealand First Party matter. The Cabinet manual is very clear. The personal conduct of a minister, the Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister Winston Peters, is a matter for the Prime Minister's responsibility. This is definitely Jacinda Ardern's problem.
Ella, do you agree with that? Should Jacinda Ardern be saying something?
Okay, so I know that this is an issue that's blown up in the media for those political pundits who care. I hang out at a university with a bunch of young people who don't. So to me, this seems like the lead up to the kind of political chicanery that will be part and parcel of our media for the next six months. In other words, I don't really care.
Okay, let's talk about Simon Bridges. So we laid the maths out pretty clearly there. He was unable to say whether or not another minor party is going to come through and support National come September. National has held that party vote support at more or less the same place it was at the last election. But in order to get into government, they need New Zealand First or the Greens to slip under five and not win an electorate seat. Is that a fair assessment, Ben?
It was always going to be necessary to kick out one of the struts from under the government. And New Zealand First was always the most vulnerable. It's failed to clear the 5% threshold both previous times that it's been in government. And, you know, New Zealand First holds within it the seeds of its own destruction. Simon Bridges' decision to rule out working with Winston Peters about 2 weeks ago is now looking very prescient in terms of the mounting concerns and mounting issues, the SFO investigation, the seeming collaboration with right-wing attack blogs to launder political attacks on journalists.
But it's a hell of a bet, isn't it, to bet against Winston Peters in an election year and for the party with the consistently polls with the highest party vote support in New Zealand to get back into government, they need to hope that Winston doesn't get in.
No, I think it's at least as big a gamble, probably more, for the Prime Minister to look back at 2008 when Helen Clark turned a blind eye to the sort of unbecoming conduct of her Foreign Minister Winston Peters during an SFO investigation. And that saw New Zealand First turfed out of Parliament and the Labor government turfed out of government. And I think the gamble here is the government's.
Ella, can you see any scenario in which New Zealand First would win a seat in, say, Northland?
I think that Shane has a high profile amongst a number of the communities in the north. He'll have to do a lot more work, particularly with Māori women after the Puti Puti, you know, thing. But the reality is, I think there are two referenda that are going to bring an interesting assortment of people who may not have voted at the last election who want to this time. And truth be told, I'm more interested in just watching the next 6 months of drama play out because it's seriously better than Game of Thrones.
Do you expect, as Ben does, that this is going to continue to drag on, especially with the New Zealand First Foundation Serious Fraud Office investigation? There is a difference, though, between 2008, of course. Winston Peters stood down as a minister in 2008. Do you think he should be standing down now?
I don't think he will. I think he's a battler and a fighter and has been extraordinarily resilient for over 30 years now. But this is, in many ways, keeping his party in the eye of the country, with for good or ill. And sometimes he's been able to turn that into his advantage.
Should he be standing down, Ben?
I would have thought that it's a no-brainer that if a senior minister's funding arrangements are being investigated by the SFO.
And we should note, Winston Peters insists that he will be vindicated, that New Zealand First will be vindicated, that he personally
is not. Look, absolutely, nothing's proven at this stage, but what we do know is that there have been more conflicting stories about the relationship between New Zealand First and Winston Peters and the New Zealand First Foundation. The official line is that it's completely independent, it's arm's length, it's nothing to do with it. But then at other times, for instance, during his Facebook live stream this week, Winston Peters was going into quite a lot of detail in terms of what he could rule out in terms of what the foundation had been up to.
Yeah, interesting, back to Simon Bridges' interview, interesting couple of comments regarding both debt and taxation there. He couldn't give us a number as to the debt level that he would be comfortable with, looks at what he considers to be lazy or poor spending from the governments in terms of making up that infrastructure deficit. What do you think we can expect in terms of National's tax relief announcement?
Well, I think our debt levels are traditionally low at the moment anyway, and we know we'd have desperate need for infrastructure around the country. So whichever government makes it through is going to have to spend big and spend wisely almost immediately after election. So the next month, I think, is going to be the time when they've both got to produce the lollies and the lolly bag.
Ben, should National outspend this government and outborrow this government?
I think they have to on infrastructure. They've been running the line for the last 2 years at least that they're the party of infrastructure. They really got gazumped by Labor with its $12 billion spending package announcement. You know, their argument now has been reduced to we're the party of infrastructure, just like the current government, which is doing all the same things we were planning to. And so in order to really differentiate themselves, which seems to be something that they value, they are going to have to bump up the spend.
All right. Thanks for your time. We will be back with the panel, Ella Henry and Ben Thomas.